Brian here, and I'm here with a sword that's been long awaited to see. A lot of people wanted to see this blade. I was very excited about receiving it. It's the French short sword from Medieval Shop. It's very much like a Type 14. It is technically within the Type 14 category, or it could even be considered a Type 12. Some early knightly swords were very similar to this as well, with a tapered point. Very good for thrusting, and still has a good point of percussion for cutting. These swords are more elegant. As you see a depiction of a sword like this, it's more tapered, comes to a point that's broad and tapers out. You'll see that in the German treatise, MS I-33. And one of my good friends is Roland Warzecke from Hamburg, Germany. And I got to hang out with him at Egan, Minnesota. So my friend Jarl Tim at Medieval Shop, as always, takes good care of me. He sent it a special gift, as well as a aventail if I wanted to hang it for my helm. Not a very nice one. But he sent this one and thought I was going to be extremely pleased, which I am. And after getting to train with Roland Warzecke, and actually he did some of his buckler techniques and some techniques directly out of MS I-33, I'm going to start off trying some techniques to show the elegance of the sword and how easy it could cut and thrust on one of our analog ballistics gel heads. This, I made a very special tough one. It has our artery in the neck, our blood concoction in the skull, and our jaw. And I use extra tough gel, so it will be a challenge for the blade, but I believe with proper mechanics, it will cut quite well. So let's, without further ado, let's get started. Start off with a technique normally done out of MSI-33, and it would be done with a buckler. So what would happen is you would slide in, and the hand would be up high if you were using without the buckler, and use the sword to parry the blow. As you're closing, you don't come with a full out shot, you just kind of come in and close where the blade catches. You grab the blade, and then you bring the sword over, throwing it out, casting it out. And after a certain point, you can allow the blade to come out as far as you need it to reach your opponent, because you're only going to get acceleration from about here to here, and the rest is just you letting the blade follow a straight line out. Perhaps if I do it this way, it'll be easier to see. But if you slide in, you catch, which I'll be showing William Warzecke's demonstration on this, and then let the blade come over just like that. All the energy is generated from the sword. This is not a technique where the body is using a whole bunch of mechanics of its own, other than the actual blade being accelerated and cast, pretty much. Well, like when you talk about the cast blow, it's a very elegant technique. And let's go ahead and see how this works out. I would have slid in, I catch you, and I'll be coming over, striking the top of it.
Hey, his ear went flying.
Haha. Alright, I glance the skull, trying to come straight down. I took a piece of the skull off and part of the head. Not what we want. Let's go ahead and try that again and see if I can get more on aim with this.
Like I told you before, it's harder to aim on this sort of thing unless you have a full target with a person.
Oh! Now that is more what I wanted to see. A little off, but we went straight into the skull and that one did not glide. And you're very much letting the blade do its own thing. But I'm still impressed. That would have killed the man outright, definitely.
And also, you've got to take into account the fact that you'd be targeting the person by moving them by their wrist, the sword.
Most certainly. You would actually be able to feel the person as you tugged and pulled the sword from his hand, and he would be turning into your cut. So on this one, it's kind of like you have that awkward feeling of nothing's there, and you have to move and try to adjust. Yeah, I agree. It's totally different. But we still got a beautiful cut. Well, that back edge coming straight down. I try it one more time just to see how it lands, if I can hit a little further over. Oh! And I would say that one was beautiful. That one, we got what we wanted at the beginning. I lined it up much better, and it went straight down in the center of the cavity of the head. So the skull is cleft directly down the center at the top. I'm extremely impressed. So it would definitely penetrate the skull, in my opinion. I think this would be a kill, other than my lousy aim earlier where I glance the skull, which can happen, but I didn't even have that happen with arrows before.
I shall try a technique where I was using a buckler. Either way, if I was using my buckler, and I was to step and cut, I just want to see what would happen if I do like a really basic imposition style, let the sword do its thing and just barely use it. I'm not going to do a big wind up. It's just like I was trying to get in and get a nice little hit there. So we'll see what happens here. Oh.
We went completely through the jaw and into our skull. So if anybody can see that, we actually cut through our actual jaw into the skull. So I think that'd be quite damaging into the cheek area here. Not bad at all. And that was just me stepping and doing a little bit of a cut with it to see what would take place.
And mind you, that is from the priest group. I'm usually not used to having my thumb on the side. It's just to see how it would behave.
Let's see what would happen if we did that with a lot more power and just come straight across.
The same type of cutting motion, if you see where my hands are going.
Right here. Of course, our head is coming free, but we've gone all the way through the jaw again and into the skull. I may be a little bit lower than I expected, but it's still a really good cut. That is brutal. Let's try something in this manner, coming across this one.
Part of the top of the actual head off. Not bad, let's aim a little bit lower.
Oh, I hit the same area, just barely took a little more off. Not what we were looking for. Just try a diagonal. Most power cut. Oof. We went straight through the side of the skull. And we only stop at our spine that actually comes up into the brain cavity, showing the view. So that's still a very impressive cut. Okay, now that we have the artery, we might as well try. Let's just try stepping in with a push cut. The sword is extremely sharp. And see what it would do to someone's throat. Ugh. Did we make it through our artery? Arteries are way tougher than regular arteries. So with push cut, you can see how deep we cut through the throat, but the artery is cut, but not all the way through. That's our only problem. The artery we use is a piece of PVC, so it's very, very tough. To actually cut this, I'm thinking it would take a tip shot, and we'll go ahead and try that right now. I hit behind the artery. Try the tip shot. I'm going to go ahead and try a tip shot because that's what's going to take to cut the artery. We hit high. It didn't hold up well. We cut the artery right underneath the jaw. Very bad spot. I didn't realize that I hit right under the jaw. I had thought that I hit lower, or I hit before, and I hit right up here. So yes, we have cut through our artery. Very tough artery, so yes, I'm impressed. I think we're down to, there's only one thing left to do to this poor guy, and that would be to take his head clean off. And it was more than adequate to cut through the spine. We shattered it. On our head, it has been severed off. You can actually see the cut into this part of the spine here. Not bad at all. See the actual cutting into the actual PVC we use as a spine. That is amazing. It was almost a complete decal. This is an amazing blade. Oh, most certainly. Very much enjoyed it. I hope you all enjoyed the video, and I will leave you with a little bit more Roland possibly demonstrating his technique. Anyway, I very much enjoyed the blade. Thank you, Medieval Shop, and far better.
So, skill slot, exactly. So both are doing the same thing here. We are creating a barrier against the opposing blade, and both are in range to thrust. So without a further step, he can thrust me in the face. Likewise, I can thrust him in the face. Okay? So this is the dangerous the distance, but I'm totally safe because I entered having created a barrier. Now, because the sword is at a standstill, I can grab it. So I'm moving out, and here comes the clamping. And now comes the twist, the snake movement. I'm turning it, and you see, hold on to it. Not cramping, but decently holding it. Because I turn it to the outside, there's this one point where he cannot hold the sword anymore. So I'm pulling the sword towards me at the same time, and this is the next step that we will train to finalize this technique. As I pull it back, I may take a step and strike this particular blow from my left shoulder, which if we do it swiftly, looks something like that. So we do it at this pace. Yeah.